In addition to the General tab, you'll find a Page Setup and Columns tab when you're looking at the format settings for a report. The page header is going to have a few settings that you can manipulate. If you'd like to include the logo, that's going to be what you see in the top left of your Intacct screen, you can. That alignment can be left, middle, or right, so it's going to be at the top of the page and will be in the left, the center, or the right of the page, depending on your choice there. The report title is going to show in the largest font at the top centered. Subtitle 1 and 2 will show in a slightly smaller font below the report title centered. And then the title comment will display in yet a smaller font to the left above the report body. You can also choose to display locations as company titles if they're on individual reports. And you can choose how you would like that title to show, whether it's the left, middle, or right. The page footer allows you to set some static text, or you can show the filters value and the prompt selections for a given report. So you can see what's set up in the filters tab, discussed in another video, as well as what the user entered for any prompts that were available to them. You have the option to set the alignment, as well as whether or not to include the footer text on all pages, and whether to include some standard text, like the page number, the report date, and the report time. We'll come back to the fonts in just a moment. We'll talk about the page settings now. Page settings are pretty much your page setup for printer. You can set your margins, your orientation, and your page size. So you can either choose to default to the page settings for a printer, you can fit to a number of pages wide, or you can set custom page sizing and column widths and column breaks to say I want this column to be this size, that column to be that size, and when to break that. We'll leave this on the default page settings and talk about the fonts now. So the fonts are set in two different areas. You have the fonts for your sections and the fonts for your columns. These are going to generally play as this being the left column and these being all the others, but this is also titling things like that. So you can kind of come through, play with these as you will, and find the settings you like. Remember, it's a report. You're not going to break the system by changing a report. Just, as always, duplicate your report before you make modifications so that you're working on your own report, not one that's maybe in active use. Your sections allow you to set a font from the selectable fonts. You can set your sizing for those fonts, the color for a PDF version, whether or not that font is bold or italic. The body is going to be all of your rows, except subgroups and totals, and headings and totals. Headings and totals, column headings, subgroups and totals, and body are going to be those main repeating sections. The rest of this is exactly what it is. Report title, company name, subtitle, subtitle are those that you find here, as well as it puts a company name at the top. And then the footer and custom headers are going to be at the bottom and at the very top. These, again, are going to allow you to manipulate the column headers as well as the text for the values in those columns.